Hello everyone, Ray here. Just wanted to bring out this topic that's been going on over the weekend about My Hero Academia, and it's just a bit of an introduction. I really don't want to talk about it because it really brings out a whole lot of other topics with it that I really want to talk about and that are pretty important to me. So, in case you haven't known, there's a little bit of drama going out within the My Hero Academia fan base, and it's like not good drama. Then again, drama it's usually never good. But My Hero Academia isn't new with drama. Like, it's always going on with some drama. Sadly, because it's a great series, it shouldn't be having all of this negative, comments about it. Because in the end, we all have opinions. In the end, we all have different likes and dislikes. So the fact that Horikoshi is getting all of this trash going on about him and his story, it just comes to show that people just can take good stuff and take away the bad stuff, quote-unquote, according to them. And I'm saying this because first they started out with the characters, you know, like they don't like the characters or how he draws a character, when it's his characters and he should be able to do whatever he wants with them, and he's writing the story that he wants to write. So why should we fans be like, well, you shouldn't do it like that? And I think this kind of clashes with my view on the Sonic thing when the first design for the movie came out. But then again, Sonic already has a design, and Horikoshi is creating his character, so that's my difference for me. And so, well, the characters is one thing, people complained about that, nothing major happened to that. And then, two weeks ago, the name for the Dr. villain was revealed, right? And there's like a bunch of controversy going around it, and the name being, well, a reference to an event that happened during World War II, I believe. And okay, it's understandable that people are getting upset about it, that people are getting offended by it, but at the end of the name, it's a name. And maybe I don't understand the implications of the name, so I really don't want to dive in into that either, because I'm not Chinese, I'm not Korean, but in the end, everyone suffers in war. War is terrible wherever you go, and if it's world war, of course all the world is gonna suffer for it. And, well, Horikoshi said that it was because he wanted Maru to be like round. Maru means circle, and Ta, it was for fat or something, so he wanted to make a reference of the doctor being chubby and round, you know? And so the coincidence of the name being kinda referencing the event of World War, just, I don't know, how do I explain it? I mean, for over here in the West, it should probably be a name, right? And if people brought out, oh, look, this is referencing to some event, then it should bring awareness. And if you're from the West, or if you're from America or Canada, I don't think you should be getting but heard about it. You weren't there. And honestly, there's nothing else you can do about it. Horikoshi can't apologize for all of Japan. And I don't know, it to me it's just a name. If people from China and Korea want to get upset about it, then I guess it's fine. But I don't know. But moving on, this weekend people started complaining about characters' birthdays, and that just drops the cup for me. Because birthdays, as people said in Twitter, because I've been going through it, right? And people supporting Horikoshi, and people are saying, well, every day is a person's birthday. You just can't help that. My dad shares his birthday with Deku and Mirio, so he's not a bad person. But people are saying, I don't know. The post was in Chinese, I think, so I have no idea what that said. But they're numbers, they're days. Your birthday could be like in any other day, and that doesn't mean you're a bad person or that you're related to an event that happened years ago on that same date. And that just doesn't happen with My Hero Academia. It happens with a lot of fandoms, and you know what's sad? I read a lot of webtoons, you know, and it's just amazing the amount of authors that had to put a disclaimer at the start of every single chapter or whatever. And I'm like, why do you have to do this? You're writing a story, you're writing what you want, and you have to put a disclaimer because people might get triggered? And like, sometimes it's okay, sometimes they give a little warning like, okay, this has sensitive material on it, and you know, you might get upset, you might not feel comfortable with it, that's fine. But sometimes these authors like literally say trigger warning. And why do you get triggered? It's a story. I was reading this really beautiful webtoon, and one of the characters, right, kisses their crush on their sleep. And there was a whole backlash because people, oh, well, you shouldn't that, and oh my gosh, I can't believe you as an author is okay with this. And I'm just, this is fiction. Why are you getting so hurt about it? And as an author myself, I really hesitate on sharing my stories, on sharing my characters, because I don't want people getting butt hurt about them, especially when everyone's going, oh, I have to be politically correct and stuff. Why are people like this? Why is it that now people have to be careful? Why is it that we have to be stepping carefully just to share what we like, just to share what we want to do, what we create, what we write, what we draw? We have to be careful because some person might be offended about it? Why? Why are people getting offended over a drawing, over fiction? It shouldn't be a reason. If you don't like it, just don't read it. Just don't look at the art. If you feel offended by it, then make sure it's for something like very important. Like, I remember, what is it? There's a lot of things going on Twitter. I just can't believe how people get offended over stuff like this all the time. Like, and it's usually with Japan, I guess, like with the whole blood donation character mascot thingy. And people are getting offended because she has a big chest. And I'm like, why? Why are you getting offended by it? It's a cartoon, it's a mascot. It's their mascot. Why do you care about it if you're not gonna go donate blood to Japan? I just feel like people are not respecting our freedom to express ourselves. We can't express ourselves anymore because we are afraid we might offend someone. I don't know. I just think that when that kind of stuff happens, as an author, we have to be smart. We have to be smart not to give the readers or quote-unquote fans, because really, if you consider yourself a fan of a series, and then you go and do this to the author, then you shouldn't be a fan. You shouldn't be considered a fan to that certain story, because you're really hurting the author, you're hurting their work, their hard work, and in the end, you're just not doing anything good for them. If you're a fan, then you're gonna go and do right to them. you're not gonna go and say bad things about them. Unless it's called for. But if you're just offended over a minor thing about making a character with a really big chest, with a really big breast, or something they said that you don't agree with, then you should really go and check your priorities. Because complaining about a fictional work instead of complaining about real things, like, there's a bunch of really bad things going on in real life, and you're complaining about things that aren't real, then you really need to go out and see what the world looks like outside. I'm afraid to go out in my town, and it's not really because it's a bad town, it's an okay town, but going out alone, it poses fear. It's really scary sometimes. And I live in a really, in a okay part of the town, but my town for a long time was considered the most violent town of the world, I think, even in Mexico, at least it was. And while things have come down, as of last year, things have started getting pretty bad again. And you guys are complaining about a fictional work that might even bring awareness to these kind of things. And that's why I love My Hero Aka, because I feel like it brings awareness. There's evil and there's good, and as good people, we should fight to defeat that evil. So why are these people complaining about minor things like how a character looks, how a character identifies? It doesn't matter. They're a character, they're their own characters, and they're by all means characters of their creator. And Horikoshi has all the right to do with them as he likes. Because at the end of the day, he's writing a great story, and he's bringing entertainment, and he's bringing people together through this story. I have no idea how many friends I've made because of the story. I love looking at fan art. I love how people are reacting to supporting Horikoshi on this. They're making great art. They're just bringing out words of courage, and that's what fans do. Fans don't go and say, go and apologize, Horikoshi, because you don't know what you're doing, because you are hurting us. Because he's not the kind of person. He's always been a great person, and he doesn't deserve this. No author deserves to be treated like this. No author deserves death threats. So if you consider yourself a fan of a certain series, of a certain manga, of anything, just be mindful that these are real people, and that they get hurt, and more than anything, they need your support.